So after the stock transfer, the next form under the inventory menu is stock adjustments. With this option, user can increase or decrease the inventory stock level, and it enables the user to adjust the stock by quantity or by value. While we clicking on the stock adjustment option, it opens to stock adjustment search page. Here user can create a new stock adjustment, and it shows already created stock adjustment details. The details we can see here like reference number, date of stock adjustment, mode of stock adjustment which is quantity or by value, reason for stock adjustment, and the description. On the right side of the data table, we have a view icon here. This view icon enables the user to access the details of stock adjustment. Now let's take a look at which all options are available in the stock adjustment search page. On the left side of the page, we have a filter option here. This filter option enables the user to filter or customize the stock adjustment data. User can filter the data by entering a particular reference number, or by selecting quantity or value, or by the date option. If the user select by date option, user need to enter the starting date along with the end date to access the data. After enter the details, click on the apply option to filter the data. Next to the filter option is a search bar. With this search bar, user can enter a particular reference number and can search or access a particular type of stock adjustment data. Next option is the add new stock adjustment. This option is using for the purpose of create a new stock adjustment. Next option is the export option. With this export option, user can export the created stock adjustment data to Excel format. Now let's take a look at how to create a new stock adjustment. For that, click on the add new stock adjustment option. While we clicking on the option, it opens to new stock adjustment form. Here user need to enter the following details to create a stock adjustment. The first one is the reference number. Here the reference number of the stock adjustment will be automatically appear. User cannot edit or change this number. It will be the continuation of the previous form. The next option is the mode. Here user can select the mode as quantity or by value. Next is the date. Here user need to select the date. And next option is the reason. Here user need to enter the reason to create the stock adjustment. By clicking on the select option, the list of available reason will be appear, and user can select the required one. Next, we have a description column here. With this description column, user can add description if required. After enter the details, the next step is to select the item to create the stock adjustment. For that, click on the item name here. Here user can enter the item name. By clicking on the enter option, the list of created items will be appear, and user can select the required one. After enter the item, the next step is to select the batch of the item. When we select the item and batch, the current quantity details of the selected item will be appear in the grid. The next is the new quantity option. Here user can enter the new quantity of the selected product. After enter the new quantity, the adjusted quantity of the product will be automatically appear here. Similarly, user can add multiple products if required. On the right side of the product grid, we have a delete icon here. This delete icon using for the purpose of delete unwanted or unnecessary products from the grid. Here we selected the stock adjustment mode as quantity. If we select the stock adjustment mode as value, then the product grid will be changed to value instead of the quantity. Here we can select the product again. After enter the product, the next step is to select the batch. After enter the batch, here we can see the current value of the selected product. The next step is to enter the new value. Here user can enter the new value. After enter the new value, the adjusted value details will be automatically appear. After enter the details, click on the save option to save this stock adjustment. While we clicking on the save option, it redirects to stock adjustment search page, and it shows the saved details here. So these are the details included under stock adjustment form. Thank you.